We welcome you to Atlanta. Good morning, everyone, on a 66-degree morning here in the beautiful city of Atlanta on this holiday weekend. Some SWAC baseball coming up in the 2023 SWAC baseball tournament. We started with 8. We're down to 6. And by mid-afternoon, we'll be down to 4. Elimination game here in this early morning start. The FAMU Rattlers lost a tough one yesterday to Alabama State as the Hornets got 5 in the 9th to beat Florida A&M. The Prairie View A&M Panthers, this is their 3rd game. They lost to Bama State, but they eliminated Texas Southern. We're just underway here in Atlanta. 2 hopper to 3rd, and the throw across is there. 1 away, and we are underway here in this first game of day number 3 is Hayter Motto with the throw across. I'm Charles Edmond, our producer James Crenshaw, and on the field, Charles Bishop with our mid-game interviews. Roger Cador, here we are. This day number 3, another early morning start. The question is pitching. Who has the most? Who's used the most? How many arms you have left, quality and quantity? Here's a ground ball, deep short. Another play in the hole. The throw across the scoop. Can't get there. It's probably a base hit on the short hop. Throwing it across.
Normally Niles make that play. He needed a little pickup at first, a little scoop. He didn't receive it. So you got to give him a hit. The ball was in the hole. But Niles have really made a name for himself from the defensive standpoint in this tournament. No one knew about him prior to that, but now everybody knows, asking the question, who is Niles? Where did he come from?
Absolutely. I bring up Michael Burrows, the freshman. He had 313 during the regular year, 167 in the postseason, as he has one on and one out. Is the key right now, Roger Cador, pitching, quality, quantity? Who has the pitching arms in the tank at this point? Both teams have played 2 games in the tournament.
Yeah, pitching is definitely – a premium. You got to, if you have the kind of pitching that's going to be able to throw strikes, Charles, if they can throw strikes, keep the ball down in the zone, and then the defense makes the plays, I think that's the team that's going to move forward. But it's not going to just be offense, because you got to stop people. And we saw that yesterday with Alabama, with FAMU.
There's a base hit slapped up the middle off the bat of Burroughs. Trevino at second. And here comes the Panthers right off the bat. Back-to-back hits with one out here in the top of the first inning. Quality at bats as we check in with Charles Bishop on the field. Charles Bishop, this time yesterday, Antoine Riggins was saying, we got to have quality at bats. You got that. You got the win, eliminating Texas Southern, and a good start here. What did he tell you before the game?
Yeah, again, big thing with regards to quality at bats. That they were working on in the batting cage this morning is continue that same offensive philosophy. Things that are on the middle third of the plate, you got to go out to right field with it, and you got to drive it back up the middle, and we just saw that with that hit.
First and second, and here's a mile-high fly ball in the center field. Could be a play at third, and it's an easy catch in center field. And the runner to third is Ty Jackson, hauls it in. And Trevino gets to third. So first and third, 2 out.
You know, you have to give Coach Riggins a lot of credit, because after his team lost to Alabama State, he held an hour and something meeting with them. And then he just didn't do that. He took them to the laboratory. He said, we have a problem. We've got to fix it. And he went to the batting cage. And they work on some particular things, and the kids came out and executed yesterday, and today they're starting out the same way. So, fam, you could be in trouble if Prairie View stay with their philosophy.
Well, Jonas at the plate for the Prairie View Panthers, an opportunity to grab the lead with first and third. Jonas, the freshman, 306 during the regular season and hitting .667 in this postseason with 4 hits and scored 2 runs. So a chance for the Panthers to grab the lead. Pitch misses outside.
The other thing I'm looking for Prairie View and Coach Riggins to be, stay with his aggressiveness. I think it helps his team when they stay aggressive.
Well, the runner at first, Burroughs. Will he do some two-out running? We'll see here. Not going. And the pitch is low and outside. Talking with Coach Jamie Shoup before the game. Obviously a tough loss, Roger Cador. You have a four-run lead, and Bama State gets five in the ninth to win it. And he said, man, it's tough. It really is tough. And, you know, his body language told a lot. He didn't want to be here at 9 o'clock in the morning for sure. Here's a ground ball right side to second, and the throw is there. Side is retired as the Rattlers get out of a jam as Perini throws out. Jonas will continue the conversation as I had a chance to talk with head coach Jamie Shoup before the game. So two stranded, two hits, two left for the Prairie View Panthers. We'll take a break here after a half inning scoreless with FAMU coming to bat after this timeout on the SWAC Digital Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
The beautiful city of Atlanta, Russ Chandler Stadium. Glad you can join us for the 2023 SWAC Baseball Tournament on this holiday weekend. A lot of activities in this city and a lot of good turnout here in Atlanta for day three of the 2023 SWAC Baseball Tournament. We started with eight. Two teams were eliminated yesterday. By mid-afternoon, two others will be eliminated. Did you see the Prairie View A&M Panthers and the FAMU Rattlers? Glad you can join us. Grambling and Bama State control their respective brackets. Those two teams are one win away from the championship game. But FAMU, Prairie View, Bethune-Cookman, have an opportunity, as well as Southern University. Roger Cador has a say whether or not they stay alive as we go to the bottom of the first inning for the Rattlers. Ty Jackson, 366 during the regular season.
And Charles, the number one seed from each bracket should control that destiny. That's why they're number one. Yeah. They proved that to be true yesterday.
Ground ball to third. Correa throws out Jackson. Ty Hanchy, as you look at the lineup for FAMU. And again, talking with head coach Jamie Shoup, man, just. And Coach Cador, you've been, I'm sure you've had games in which, you know, even in the postseason that you had them. You had them on the hook and you let them off the hook.
Yes, I've had.
That's one, the body language of Jamie Shoup just told it all. Like, but he did say, hey, a sign of a good parent, a good person, a good team, when your back's against the wall, how do you respond? Yeah. So we'll see how his team responds.
Can I share a story with you?
Sure.
1986, my second year coaching. We're playing in Alexander for the SWAC championship. Against, guess who we had? Jackson State. And one of my, you know, back in the days, they could have a courtesy runner for the catcher. And we put in a senior to run for the catcher. And one of my freshmen, well, he was a sophomore, Adel Davenport, hits a monster home run out of the park. And the guy running from the catcher didn't touch home plate.
Wow. Yes.
And so we rather be up three runs, we're up now two. Going to the top of the ninth or the bottom of the ninth, whatever it was. Jackson State catcher hits a home run and beat us by a run. You talk about a heart wrenching. So those things happen. You know what I'm saying? And we lost the conference tournament. Would have won it the second year as a head coach. I had to wait until the next year to win it.
Yeah.
You know.
But what was the speech to your team? Just like Coach Shoup. I mean, you had a 4-run lead. And so going into the ninth inning, obviously Bama State rallied and won it. But what could you say, or was it it's best not to say much, knowing that you got to have an early morning game here?
Yeah, you know, you don't want to make them feel bad.
There's a shot to short. Good play. Going against him right there. Donato hauls it in. Two away. It'll bring up Jared Weber.
You know, Coach, as a 13-year-old, I remember that game.
You do?
I remember that game, sir.
Yes. Yeah. It's a kid, the catch who hit is from Compton, California. I tried to recruit him, so I know. You know, and came from a JC, came from Compton Community College. So I'm saying, what, you don't want to say too much. They already deflated. They hurt. You know, so you come back out, and you know, you try to build them up. You know.
Yeah, that's got to be just excruciating.
Now, we talking about 86. Fast forward to 2023.
Yeah.
They say kids are different. You got me?
Yeah.
So we'll see, even though it's two different situations. But the thing is the same thing. You had victory in your hand, in the palm of your hand, and it slipped away, you know?
Yeah. We'll see. I mean, that's one of the tough ones that you'll see in the SWAC baseball tournament. You have a 4-run lead and just had – as they say, Bama State on skates a little bit, but the Hornets
on skates.
When you're skating, you're just kind of sliding along.
And a banana peel under there.
Yeah, things do happen. But that's baseball, as they say. We see it all the time. But we'll see what happens here.
It happened in all phases of sport, football, yes. Basketball, too. You know, it's tough. You and I were doing that game, Charles? Oh.
No, sir.
You were at home relaxing.
the swing and a miss. Weber hitting .667 going into this game in the postseason. Side is retired. A 1-2-3 inning for this pitcher. Oh, we'll take a break right here. Matthew Crawl, 4-4 during the year. A 1-2-3 inning for him. We'll take a break here. Top two coming up, Correa, Castro, and Donato, 6, 7, and 8 coming up after this timeout on the SWAC Digital Network.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Elimination games here for the Prairie Panthers and for FAMU. As you look at one of the sponsors of Southwestern Athletic Conference, Cricket Wireless, as we're underway, top two. And they're going up swinging, Roger Cato.
Oh,
Cato,
the
Correa.
Ball, he almost got away from him. Ooh, Charles, it was like a hot potato there for a second.
We'll take another look at it. It's Correa jumping on the first pitch.
Yeah. Catches clean there, then.
Oh, yeah, bobbled
yeah, yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Stays with it.
And his arm is good enough that he was able to put a little more mustard on it.
Jalen Niles at short. Quickly one away. And the first pitch to the catcher, Castro. Strike called. Our home plate umpire, Augustus Griffin, with Joseph Smith at first, Calvin Hill at second, and Derek Everett at third. Foul off to the right side.
The Now family name comes from a family of really good athletes, and it's a really special name in the Alabama area, particularly South Alabama and the Mobile area.
A check swing. They check it first, and he went around and quickly two away. Castro swinging a good stick here in the postseason, 667 in the tournament, and quickly two away. And it'll bring up Amar Donato, the shortstop. Donato just 125 in the tournament, hitting 248 during the regular season. Quickly two away. Fastball high.
You know, Charles, while we're at it, we'd like to promote the fact that HBCUs are doing a good job of recruiting. And Prairie View have got, according to Perfect Game, the highest ranking pitcher to sign at HBCU. Prairie View got a commitment yesterday of Corey Baddeley. You remember Earl Baddeley was the catcher with the Minnesota Twins? And they got his grandson committed to Prairie View on yesterday. So that's really good. And he came out of that Pro Youth Foundation program headed by one of my former players, Chip Lawrence. And they have many other kids out of the program who also are committed to HBCU. So here we have someone came out of an HBCU is sending kids back to HBCUs. So we like to highlight that, let people know that there are people who cares and love HBCUs.
And there's a very caring swing right there off the bat of Donato, a base hit in the left center field. Jaden Williams at the plate, the center fielder. Jaden Williams during the season 195, hitting 500 in this SWAC tournament, his fifth at bat, bottom of the lineup. Well, you talked about it, Roger Cato, and I see it and I follow it, all the different teams in the conference on social media and some of the signees of baseball players, the transfer portal. We haven't talked about that, a throw to first.
Right.
You're seeing a lot of movement in all sports with the transfer portal, and some of our SWAC schools are getting some pretty good talent. What are your thoughts as the transfer portal is – I think probably when in your latter years of coaching, the transfer portal was really warming up. It's now red hot right now.
It's scorching hot right now. Yeah, it's scorching hot because now if a kid don't like the way you look at him, he's leaving. You know what I'm saying? So, but you got to be careful with that transfer portal because a kid could be at a big school but only have 15, 16 at-bats or two or three inning pitch. Well, there's a reason he's only had that. You got me? So, you know, but there are some good kids there that if a big Power 5 school recruited him, he obviously had some talent. So if we could get some of those kids coming down to us, then we'll be okay. But particular arm, Charles, that's the one area as I look here. If you can, each team can add a quality arm here and there, they could really be good because there's been some really competitive games. I mean, when even the people from MLB think that the game has been extremely competitive.
Runner going here at a foul off to the right side as Prairie View continues to stay aggressive. I mean, you're seeing that at in every sport at all levels in terms of the transfer portal. And we've talked about it the last couple of days in terms of pitching. You know, both of these teams have used five pitchers in their game so far. And of course, with this being an elimination game, every arm is available.
And I hope Prairie View stay aggressive because I think that's where Coach Riggins' team is going to have a better chance to have success if they stay aggressive because they're not going to hit the ball out of the park. So you need to stay aggressive, add pressure to the defense.
So the number nine hitter, Jaden Williams, two out, runner at first, scoreless, top of the second inning. Runner going here, ball four. Panthers have two on. They stranded two in the first. Charles Bishop, they have two on in the second. Tell you what, Antoine Riggins, we've talked with him the last couple of days, very calm, very matter of fact, no panic at all, despite the fact his team lost the first game, came back, eliminated Texas Southern has two on here in the second.
To be very honest with you, it's almost like a quiet confidence with Coach Riggins. He knows he has a team that can hit the baseball, and he feels like, you know, that some of the things that they've really been going over, he has an opportunity to really drive in some runs and turn some heads. So it's very interesting to watch this Prairie View team, especially their at-bats.
Two on for the leadoff hitter, Wise, and grounded to third his last time up. This is the first of two elimination games. We've got another one coming up next. Southern University and Bethune-Cookman. Grambling and Bama State control their respective brackets. Both of those teams are one win away from the championship. We might have baseball tomorrow. We might not, depending on what happens with those teams. There's a foul off to the right side. I tell you what, Roger Cator, when you win those first couple of games and you control the bracket, how much can you exhale as a coach when you're in that situation? Okay, or do you exhale at all? Does that put a little? Does that give you a little more angst?
A little more.
A little more. Okay.
Yeah. No, I think it really makes you. But it's more about the kids than you. You got me, because they're the one have to go out there watch it.
Against the rail.
Good play.
And did he get it? Yes. Another good play on the right field side this time, up against the rail. Let's take another look at it here. We saw one yesterday down the left field line, and a heck of a play here at first as Grieco leaning, almost a carbon copy of what we saw in left yesterday, holds the ball up, the umpire looking for the ball. He thought the ball might have went out of play, and he says, I got it. Inning over. So the Panthers strand two. They've left four, and we'll take a break here. Bottom two coming up. Grieco will lead it off. Bastardo and Perini coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
You look at Sebastian Echo, who made a nice play at first on a foul ball. Stepping to the plate for FAMU, the Rattlers from Tallahassee, Florida, the capital of the state of Florida. Bottom of the second underway. These pitchers, Roger Cator, are working pretty quickly here. Not a lot of laboring. They're just firing it and getting it done here in the early part of this game.
And throwing strikes the key right here, Charles. I mean,
here's the 1-1, misses outside.
The field is going to play early. I found out, this being the third day, that the field does play bigger early in the morning.
Grieco pulls it foul off to the right side, and the count is 2-2. Back to the we talked about the transfer portal, Roger Cator, okay, in terms of getting more talent. Are you seeing that based on your conversations and based on what you've seen and talking with coaches? You feel like SWAC teams are getting more talent from the portal. There's a ground ball right side, right center, base hit. Grieco with a good play in the field and helps himself at the plate, a single in the right center to lead it off. And Michael Bastardo at the plate, hitting .625 in this postseason. Ninth at bat, four runs batted in, tied with Grieco for the team lead in this postseason. So the leadoff is on for the first time. And he jumps on the first pitch. Foul territory. Is there a play? Yes, sir. One out. Catch is made behind the plate. One away as Castro hauls it in.
The catcher looked like a little young boy. He got a baby face.
He made a nice play pretty deep backstop here. We've seen wild pitches score runs.
And we've seen some of them bounce off the wall, go right back to the catch.
Yeah.
We've seen that on a couple of occasions.
We sure have, those caroms. There's a fly ball. A lot of fly balls here in this game. To center, and it's hauled in at center by Donato.
You know, and that's one of the things early games you get to see what you're seeing now. Kids just ain't really fully in the game yet. You know what I'm saying? But I think as the game heats up toward the second part of the game, you'll see guys take better swings.
Adam Hader-Mota at the plate at 297 during the regular season. 333 is 10th at bat here in the postseason.
You know, Coach, I was going to ask with regards to FAMU possibly being a little flat, how was their at-bats early in this game?
Yeah, you know, you could tell that the at-bats aren't what the quality of bats we saw yesterday yet, you know. But I think as the game progresses, we'll see a little change in their approach to hitting.
The obvious question, do you detect any hangover from the tough loss yesterday?
Just a little. Not a lot, just a little. About what you expect. I mean, you know, you're still dealing with the human element.
Pitch to Hader-Mota as we had a stolen base by Rico. So an opportunity for the Rattlers, a single and a wild pitch. And now the Rattlers have an opportunity here to grab the lead in the bottom of the second inning. Another wild pitch, runner to third.
That's the easiest way to get a run at home is to throw a couple of wild pitches and then you have a little boo-boo somewhere.
So Rico will single to right center. A wild pitch got him to second and third. So the best opportunity so far for FAMU. Prairie View has stranded two runners in each of the first two innings. They've stranded four. Rattlers have a runner in scoring position here.
And Charles, with two outs and the base runner in scoring position, it's when you want to get the hit. We're going to use the Joe Carter theory here. Joe Carter was one of the greatest. Batted 219, drove in 131 runs in, batted in, and then hit the great home run in the World Series off of Mitch Williams. And he was smiling, as his smile was as wide as the field.
I was just about to say, Mitch Williams will co-sign that.
Yeah, he will co-sign. Yeah. I was waiting for Charles to say, Charles, touch them all, Joe. You'll never hit a bigger one.
Well, speaking of touching them all, this Prairie View pitcher crawled, touched them all right there with a strikeout. A good opportunity for the Rattlers. Rico with a single, a wild pitch got him to second and third, and he was stranded. First runner stranded for the Rattlers. Both teams with opportunities through two. Top three coming up. Top of the lineup coming up for Prairie View. Scoreless elimination game. Day number three. Game one. We'll be back after this on the SWAC Digital Network. Good view here from Atlanta. Glad you could join us, McNeese Ballpark. It's pretty good crowds so far, especially in the late afternoon sessions here in this beautiful city. There's a bunt foul. Review continuing to be aggressive. It's a foul ball down the left side.
If I can say something about the crowd yesterday, I've been to many, many SWAC championships, almost as more than maybe the commissioner. He's just a baby. But I've seen yesterday crowd enthusiasm was as good as I've ever seen.
Really?
The one that had the Alabama State, the FAMU game, I mean, it was just electric. It was electric.
Yeah.
And that's what you want to see, you know.
I think that rivalry, and it's kind of grown on me a little bit, just how big those two rivals are. And, you know, no secrets there. They know each other during the regular season. Charles Bishop and about as exciting of a SWAC game as you're going to find. Come from behind victory, down four runs. There's a fly ball into left center field. This ball's well hit, a little bit of wind, and it's caught in center field. One away by Jackson. That's one of your better games, Charles Bishop, that you'll find in the postseason. You're down four runs. You're down to your last at bat and found a way.
You know, you looked around and you saw people standing. I mean, the hair was on your neck yesterday. I mean, that was just a tremendous ball game. And just looking at the faces of the FAMU fans, really dejected walking out of there. But the flip side of that, the Alabama State fans couldn't have been more elated. I mean, it was a tremendous atmosphere yesterday.
I had the pleasure of talking with Coach Vasquez after it, and he said, man, this was a hell of a game, you know. And Charles was somewhere sipping on a soda pop, you know. You know, couldn't be found.
Actually, I was eating some nachos. Here's a ground ball, and the hold is short, and the throw across is low, but there. Low throw, but out. From the shortstop, Niles. I was eating some nachos, and I saw that Bama State had the lead. And then sipping on some lemonade, I pull up my phone again on social media. All I saw was, wow, was one of the big comments. And I said, oh, my goodness, what happened?
Bama didn't have the lead until it was over. Well, they had it in the first inning. And then they didn't lead until they won it.
Yeah.
In the bottom of the ninth, you know what I'm saying? Because they had gone – the pitcher did a really good job for FAMU, keeping them off balance.
Burrow's at the plate, and his pitch misses. But it just shows you got to play 27 outs, Roger Cador. Every manager has said you got to play 27 outs, and until you get 27 outs, you haven't done anything.
Yeah.
And there's a line shot to third. Inning is over. Man, quick start to this one as Adermana hauls it in. And we go to the bottom of the third inning. Scoreless when we come back. 8-9-1. Niles will lead it off. Jalen Niles followed by Evan Badger. And top of the lineup, Ty Jackson. Coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network. And we welcome you back to Atlanta. Bottom of the lineup for the Rattlers, Jalen Niles, the shortstop for FAMU. here in this bottom of the third inning. No runs, three hits for the Prairie View Panthers, and they've left four runners on base. No runs, one hit, and one stranded for the Rattlers. We're in the bottom of the third inning. Jalen Niles, the shortstop, hit 231 during the regular season. 444 his average in the postseason. 10th at bat, four hits. It just shows you, Roger Cador, what you've done in the regular season, can you get it done in the postseason? You've seen players with lofty averages kind of fall off a little bit, but Charles Bishop at the same time, you have guys that you don't expect lower averages getting it done in the postseason. A swing and a miss here. Down goes Niles.
That's what it's about. It's about being a star in the postseason. And I tell you what, Count Antoine Riggins, amongst the fans of Jalen Niles, he has really been impressed by his instinctual movements over there at shortstop.
So have I. And the people from MLB, by the way.
Evan Badger at the plate.
Boy, and this is, if you want to ever make a name for yourself, you have to do it at the right time when the right people are in the house. And, you know, with this HBCU All-Star game going on, he needed to put up a good showing, because shortstop is one in the position they haven't determined who is going to be there.
So right now, Roger Cador, is it safe to say, and you're a voter, here's a fly ball into right. And it's caught in right and quickly two away. As a right fielder, Weiss hauls it in. Is it right now, if a ballot was put in front of you right now, Roger Cador, for this All-Star game, is it a tough ballot for you to fill out right now?
Depend if it comes off of the web or what. No, it wouldn't be that tough. You know, the beautiful thing is, Charles and I, we're going to see you won't be for the second part. We'll see the remaining of the games today. You got me?
Uh-huh.
And you know what? Being the kind of person I am, I'm going to get his input, and as yours and Centurio. I'm going to ask for y'all opinion on players, because we want to be fair. When I go to the
pitcher slips. Oh, that's tough.
Well, he slipped because he didn't go there with the control, anticipating that it's going to be a tough play. I have to run there with balance and put my body in position, so if I catch it, I can make the throw. So let's see what we can see.
Yeah, let's take a look at that. Now, you attribute that to...
You see, he was never under control. So even had he picked it up, he couldn't make the throw. You have to move... go over there, run there, and immediately be under control when you pick up the ball. That is something coaches work with pitchers on a lot, because, again, it's a difficult play to make.
I hand you at the plate. What I was going to mention on that play, would he have slipped at 3 o'clock in the afternoon with the warmer weather, the dew evaporating? Do you attribute that to this being a 9 a.m. start and the grass is a little wet?
That's a good question.
Here's a base hit in the right field, and Jackson to third, and Ty Hanchy keeps the inning going for FAMU. First and third.
That's a good question, because being in the third inning, they would have watered the field, the grass a little anyway, but you got a little different water on it. The dew is different than the water at 3 o'clock. You got me?
Yeah.
You know, the dew has a little residue. It's going to make it a little slippery. People may not believe that, but God water is better than man's water. Or the water from the sky, the dew from the sky. You got me?
It's 67 degrees here in an early morning start. Strike called here.
Try doing that in Mississippi and Louisiana. Huh?
It's a little muggy over there. It's been very comfortable here all week long, and the rain's going to hold off, it appears. Chance for the Rattlers here, Roger Cador, first and third. A tough break as the Rattler pitcher, the Panther pitcher, Crawl, fell down trying to get a ground ball, and then a base hit behind that, so first and third.
We've got a two-out situation again. Who does the job with two out? It's the team that's going to win. You know, you're going to have to get two out hits, which proved what Alabama State did yesterday. They got a couple of big two out hits, you know, in the bottom of the ninth.
A two out opportunity here. Here's a shot down the right side. It's going to drop in for a base hit. One run scores. Jackson scores. And a double as Anchieta's third, and Weber an RBI double, and the Rattlers strike first.
Well, look how innocent it was not making that play at the mound. Innocent. Two outs. This is how you win them, baby.
And, Coach, one of Antoine Riggins' observations about this FAMU team is they are phenomenal at taking advantage of your mistakes, and we see it with this first run here.
Yeah. And it's still not over because you got the meat of your order since we're in the South, not the heart.
You have a big part of their order, and Greco skies this one a mile high.
Watch out.
And it's going to be caught at third, circling that ball and finally finding it as Korea, but the side is retired. Some two-out action for the Rattlers. A run on three hits, and they strand two. They've stranded three. The Panthers have stranded four. We'll take a break here. Third of the way through. 1-0. The Rattlers with the lead. 4, 5, and 6 coming up for Prairie View after this timeout on the SWAC Digital Network. And we welcome you back to Atlanta. Glad you can join us here on the SWAC Digital Network as we are underway in the top of the fourth inning.
It hadn't been a lot of action yet, but we'll see what happens.
The Panthers trail 1-0 here in the fourth. Marshall Jonas at the plate. Fastball is high. We'll see now with this lead as the righty Dallas tees 1-3 during the season.
It's been a pattern all series, Charles, tournament-wise. Whenever the team scored it, they usually walked in the leadoff in. Except this one won't happen. Pop up.
In foul territory, it's going to be caught at first. A lot of fly balls early on. Rico with the catch. One away. And that is five in a row set down. Korea at the plate. And the end ball one. Korea grounded to short his last time up. When we say five in a row, five straight set down, just following the ebbs and flows of the pitcher. When a pitcher gets on a roll, when you get set down 5, 6, 7, 8 in a row. We had a situation where 12 in a row was set down the other day. Roger Cador. So when a pitcher is, what we're saying is that when a pitcher is in a groove, they usually go right up and down the order.
Yeah, that's the key. And it's all because they are initiating the aggression by throwing strike. You got to throw strikes and force hitters to swing the bat. Because he's FAMU, for instance, really have a good defense behind the pitcher. You know what I'm saying? They play really good, solid defense, so I wouldn't be afraid to throw strikes. Then the next thing you take into consideration, the element. How does the park plays? The park plays relatively big in the morning, so you have to make them put the ball in play.
All righty, Matthew Crawl. One sail away from him, 2-2. Crawl 4-4 with a .638 earned run average, started 11 games during the season.
So he must have been that number three guy. Third game starter, you know what I'm saying? If he started that many games.
Count is 2-2.
And he's done his job. He's thrown strikes, stayed out of the middle of the plate. See that ball on the outer half of the plate? They can hit it, but they can't do a whole lot with it.
Ty Jackson hauls it in. That is 7 in a row set down, Charles Bishop. So this pitcher has the lead. His team gave him the lead and is a little in the comfort zone right now.
Yeah. So you got a young man, Castro, who's small in stature. So you sit on the outside corner. Even though that pitch was more on the inside, you want to sit toward the outside part of the plate and try to make him pull the ball, which is the catcher doing, sitting outside. See, this is all they could do with it.
A ground ball to second and another quick inning as the second baseman, Perini, throws out Castro on the side, is retired. And that's 8 in a row set down. We'll take a break here quickly, bottom of the fourth inning. Rattlers coming to plate. The Rattlers have the lead 1-0 with Bastardo, Joseph Perini, and Adam Hatermota coming up after this timeout on the SWAC Digital Network. Yeah, Michael Bastardo will lead it off. As you can see, and Bastardo jumps on the first offering here into foul territory. Shortstop ranging over and makes the catch, one away as Donato hauls it in. Man, Roger Cato, a fast start to this one, jumping on the first pitch. A lot of fly balls, one out.
Well, you know, people are trying to make something happen. And a lot of fly ball means that they'll dip in their back shoulder or the back bat is dragging through the strike zone. It's a multitude of things that could be going on. Again, the telling tale is going to be what happened. You see, that's not a quality swing on the first pitch. A lot is going to be told as we get into 7th, 8th, and 9th inning, who really want to win this game.
It's 1-0.
Now, they think they want to win it now, but they're not exerting enough effort to do it.
It's the 1-0. And hit him.
Reality will set in as you get closer to the end of the game.
Verini hit by a pitch. I'm always amazed, Roger Cador, as we look at this HBP, if you're scoring at home. Yeah, grazed him above the right knee.
Above the right knee, that's not good.
So base runner for FAMU. They already have a 1-0 lead. And Hedermota at the plate. He struck out his last time up. Hedermota ground ball to third. Could be two over the second for one over the first. The scoop save. 5-4. Good hustle.
Now we got to see.
Let's take a look at it here.
Yeah. It was a good play. Not a slow roller. Difficult turn right here.
And he slid to get out of the way. Yeah, it looks like he just got there. So quickly, two out runner at first. There's a base hit. Taking it the other way off the bat of Niles. Hedermota stops at second.
Again, we got a runner in scoring position with two outs. So we'll see what happens here.
Evan Badger at the plate. I'm always amazed, Roger Cador, in these 9 a.m. games. And you know, we've been doing these 9 a.m. games. The format is the format, 9, 12, 3, and 6. How teams can get themselves ready to play a 9 a.m. game when typically in the SWAC you have games at 6 p.m., 3 p.m. on Saturdays, and 1 p.m. on Sundays. That's kind of the starting time for games in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, conference series on Friday, Saturday, Sundays. For teams to be able to do this at 9 a.m., I'm amazed, honestly. I'm barely here at 9 o'clock in the morning.
Really?
Yeah, but I'm just amazed at the players, how they can get themselves up and get going this early, a check swing here.
But, Charles, they do play in high school. They do play a lot of AAU ball or travel ball, and they would play 9 o'clock game in the morning, so. So they're accustomed to do it, just don't do it at the college level.
Yeah, I was going to say, at this level, yeah. Very unusual pitch, low. Like the home plate umpire, Augusta Griffin was going to call it a strike, backed off of it. Count is 3-0.
But if anybody can do it, it's young people, resilient. That, you know, they can do a lot. Yeah.
Here's the 3-0. And the bases are loaded.
Two outs. Now, something big could happen. Remember, everything happened with two outs. The last time they had nobody on it, the little dribbler the pitcher didn't make. Then he hits the hitter. Then he gets a single. Now he gets a walk. Let's see what happens. Well, okay, the pitching coach goes out to talk.
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely a situation where you want everyone on the same page. We'll keep it right here. Well, Charles Bishop, you're going to have the mid-game interviews coming up in the next half inning or so. Your thoughts here, chances for both of these teams.
Yeah, chances for both of these teams. One of the things I've taken a look at, especially these teams, the pitchers, they have been getting into a groove. We saw that yesterday with Connor Judy, with Gremlin. He had 12 ground outs yesterday. So to Coach's point, once these pitchers kind of get in the groove, things go well when you throw strikes.
And we're seeing that, obviously, from FAMU's pitcher, Dallas Tease. He has set down 8 in a row, so he's in a little bit of a rhythm. And right now, the Rattlers are trying to continue their rhythm at the plate and add to their lead. They have the bases loaded in the bottom of the fourth inning. For the leadoff hitter, Ty Jackson, pitch strike call on the inside corner.
You know what I used to tell my hitter, my pitchers, Charles? Just remember batting practice, how many fastball they see that they know coming and they can't didn't do anything with. You have to remind them, give them the confidence, and make them paint the picture for them. You want to be like Michelangelo, the great artist? You're into the art.
I am not into the art. I know Michelangelo. A couple of pitches that Jackson didn't exactly care for, one inside corner, one outside corner. He's got to protect the plate. Jammed right back to the pitcher. Inning is over. He was sawed off right there. If that was a wooden bat, he would have sawed that one off. And the pitcher crawl gets out of a jam. Boy, going the other way. It was Jackson and the underhand toss. Side is retired. So you had a fielder's choice, a walk, and a single, and three stranded. The Rattlers have stranded six. We'll take a break here. And we have played four. Mid-game interviews coming up. Top of the lineup for the Panthers. You have Weiss, and you have Donato and Williams coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network. Panthers coming up top of the fifth inning. Amar Donato, Jaden Williams, and Garrison Wise. Let's get our mid-game interviews. Charles Bishop is in the dugout with Prairie View head coach Antoine Riggins.
Yeah, down here with Coach Riggins. Coach, you just called your team together here in the dugout. What was your message to the team?
Get back to doing what we do best. Just hitting the ball the other way. Right now he's able to compete against us because we're not patient. We're not letting the ball travel. We're not hitting the ball the other way. Hitting the ball the other way, so. Once we get back to doing that, then we'll have a good chance.
Your pitcher, Matthew Crawl, he's been doing a good job of kind of keeping FAMU hitters off balance.
Yes. He was getting ahead early. He's falling behind here late, but he was able to make pitches to get out of the tough situation. So he's doing a pretty good job right now.
Sure thing. Let you get back to it, Coach.
I appreciate it, Charles Bishop and Antoine Riggins in the bottom inning. We'll talk with Coach Shoop of Florida A&M, and he talked about patience, Roger Cador, and I think you mentioned it early on, the patience at the plate at this point, because right now this Rattler pitcher Tease has set down eight in a row. How would you assess the patience for the Panthers at the plate?
Yeah, well, it's hard to be patient when the kid pitcher is getting out in front, so that's the most difficult part of it. But you know what, again, you just got to wait for him to make the mistake. And he'll make it, get the ball over the plate, because he's not overpowered. And that's when they got to take advantage of it, like this one.
This ball is well hit deep center field. And with this urban wind that Charles Bishop has talked about, left to right, blowing in at the moment, and that kept it in the ballpark. Ty Jackson hauls it in.
He did something you don't get to see very often. He took his cap off.
I was just about to make that observation. He took his cap off. Yeah. What was that about?
Well, I don't get to see that much. You know, when Willie Mays played, you know, he wore cap small, so when he go after it, it would come off. All of that was created by Willie Mays, creating excitement, so when he ran, the cap would fly off. Well, isn't that beautiful? You learn a lot, Charles. You're too young.
Yes, indeed. The say hey kid. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Well, let's take a look here at this bunt attempt. The home plate umpire says it was a foul ball. And Antoine Riggins is pointing, maybe assuming that it hit him, but it's a foul ball.
Did you know how Willie Mays got the Say Hey Kid name?
Enlighten us.
Well, I was waiting for a response. I know Charles wanted to know. You may not want to know. You're not into history that much. Charles, you know, he had a bad few days up in the big league in 1951, and he begged Leo DeLip DeRocha to send him down, and Leo wouldn't do it. And he went, you know, Monty Irvin was his roommate, and he cried in Monty Irvin's arm. And so the next night, then Monty said, relax, go out and play.
Fly ball down the left side. And it's going to be circled under and caught in left for the second out by Weber.
So Willie goes out the next day, and he hits two home runs. And Leo DeLip, who is the manager, saw that he had the right rider near Willie Mays, and he said, say hey, kid. And the say hey kid was born, because he said it at the right time. He had the right rider there. He said, say hey, kid.
What a jewel you are, Coach. I appreciate
that. Man. Well, you have to be able to tell true stories.
We're getting true stories, history, and baseball all in one. Here's
and,
a
football. And I ball. Didn't get it off the wheel.
Well, two out. Wise at the plate. He's 0 for 2. Grounded to third and fly to second. Another foul ball off to the right side. And I was we were talking about Ty Jackson taking his cap off on his way to that catch early in the inning. Just, I mean, he did it so fluidly. I mean, if he kind of fumbled with that,
it
was out the middle, a base hit. Wise with a single. And that breaks the string of 10 straight set down.
And this is what Coach Riggin wanted his players to do, hit the ball back up the middle. You know, if you could create fear in the pitcher, that's half the battle won.
So Zachary Trevino, 1 for 2, stands in. Then a bunch of runners stranded in this game. The Panthers have stranded 4. FAMU has stranded 6. Runner going. Swing and a miss. Oh, I got him hung up.
He should have never stopped.
Here's the rundown. Got executed and the diving tag, and he's out.
Well, it wasn't a hit and run. It was a direct steal because it was 2 outs. Okay.
Let's take a look at it right here.
It should have been a direct steal. It's 2 outs. So he decided he couldn't make it, so he came back. He had a good jump. But I tell you what, the one asset Florida A&M does have is the catcher does have a good throwing arm. Once they got him in the middle of the pack there, he had no way to get out.
Well, that takes care of the Panthers. A single, CS, nobody left. We'll take a break here. Bottom 5 coming up. We'll hear from Coach Jamie Shoup on the other side here on the SWAC Digital Network. We are in the home half of the 5th inning. Rattlers at the plate and a 1-0 lead as we're underway bottom of the 5th inning. I'm sure head coach Jamie Shoup pleased at this point, Charles Bishop, as you have him in the dugout.
Yeah, down here with Coach Shoup. Coach Shoup, your starting pitcher, Dallas Tease, is doing a phenomenal job keeping the Panthers off stride, if you will.
He's doing a great job, and we need that. We're a little flat after the disappointing loss last night. It's hard to come out and get a little motivation. So somebody's got to do something offensively to get us going a little bit, and hopefully it'll be that this inning.
I was going to ask about that in terms of just bouncing back from the tough loss. How do you assess your at-bats early in this game?
Well, so far, so good. We're swinging too many first pitches is what's getting us in trouble. I think last inning, the first four guys swing at first pitch, and that two all made first pitch out. So can't do that. You know, we talked to our guys about last out a little bit today. And, you know, you just got to be good. It's easy to be good when things are going good, but you got to be good when things aren't going good. And that's what's going to define you in life, you know, not only in baseball but in life. So when things are bad, you still got to be good. You still have to have a good attitude. And I thought we were lacking a little bit there last night at the end.
Sure thing. Thank you, Coach.
All right. Coach made some good points. It's easy to be good when everything is going good. But in life, it doesn't work that way, Charles, all the time. You know?
And Trevino flies out to Burroughs for the first out.
Good interview, Jay. I'm Charles. Really good interview.
Swing and a miss here. As Weber at the plate. Weber doubled and struck out. This pitch strike called.
To be honest with you, Charles, after the last three games we had yesterday, we were 3 of 4 games. It was really tough, you know.
Weber, a mile high, medium depth center, and it's going to be caught in center. And Williams.
You know, we had a whole lot of action. We could use a little break, can't we?
What do you think of jumping on the first pitch? Let's piggyback off of what Jamie Shoup talked about, swinging at too many first pitches. As a coach, does that disturb you when that happens?
No. If they're taking good quality swings, they haven't taken quality swings because they've been weak, lazy fly balls or ground ball. You got me? I have no problem with a kid taking swinging at the first pitch as long as it's aggressive because you could do damage. That tells me if you're swinging at it, you're looking for a particular pitch. You got me? Now, you can't go up there looking for a curve and swing at a fastball or looking for a fastball. You can swing at a curveball because they do make mistakes. I need to make that point. I'm glad we're talking about it. If you're looking for a curveball and you get a fastball, you can't swing because you're not going to catch up.
Yeah.
But you can look for a fastball and get a curveball and swing. You got me? So we needed to make sure we make that distinction. Why we were saying that, because fastball are going to come in faster than a curveball.
Right now the count is 2-2. A good battle here at the plate. Inning over. So that takes care of the Rattlers. 5 complete. Low scoring game so far. 1-0. The Rattlers with the lead. Top of the 6th inning coming up. Trevino, Burroughs coming up for Prairie A&M. 2, 3, and 4 coming up after this timeout with Alex Martinez here on the SWAC Digital Network.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in 2 words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Beautiful Atlanta, Georgia, McNeese Ballpark. First year of the SWAC Conference at the 2023 SWAC Baseball Tournament here in Atlanta. 12 months ago, we were in Birmingham. As we're underway in the top of the 6th inning. Zach Trevino leading it off, 1-for-2. Infield single and fly to center. Pitch misses outside, 1-1. One to nothing. Rattlers with the lead. Top of the sixth. Here's a bunt foul. RBI double by Weber. And the only run scored, actually, could have been prevented. It was a single by Jackson. The pitcher for the Panthers, Crawl, fell down trying to get a ground ball back to him. That led to a couple of more hits and the run by FAMU.
I think you said if he had charged the ball more under control, that's short hang up.
It's going to be caught in left center.
A lot of fly balls, Charles. And you could see the swings are not full healthy cuts. You know what I'm saying? I want to see him driving the ball.
You haven't seen that. The wind, no wind to speak of right now. Michael Burrows, 1-for-2, an infield single and grounded to third. The loser of this game is eliminated. The winner of this game comes back later to take on Bama State. Bama State and Grambling control their respective brackets. If Bama State wins later, they're in the championship game. The winner of this game will take on Bama State. If Bama State loses, we'll be back here tomorrow. Bama State and Grambling controlling the brackets. You got the top teams in the East and the West.
So Vegas was right. No, Vegas had nothing to do with who was the number one.
There's a dribbler foul off to the left side.
The way the season played out in each division was right thus far. Am I correct? That's the best way to put it?
Yeah.
Yeah. They deserved it. They've proven that they were number one seeds.
And Michael Bastardo on deck. He had a couple of home runs yesterday, and here he'll be coming up here in the bottom half. So for the Panthers, an opportunity here. Alex Martinez at the plate. He fouled out and fly to center. A walk here, Roger Cador, a chance for the Panthers.
Remember, walk starts a lot of problems.
A one-out walk.
You know, normally when they lead the inning, I think it's 63% of the time that runner scores. You know, we saw it last night. It scored almost all the time, you know.
You expect some running here? Not going here.
Not going. I would put him in action. You need to have – they're at their best when they're being aggressive, you know. They're not going to be able to have a guy staying in there and hit the ball out of the park. You need to create movement in the defense.
Pitch strike called. 1-0, low-scoring game.
And he had the right pitch to do it, 1-1. Now, this is not a good pitch to try and hit a run on, because the pitcher could be trying to miss out of the zone.
Pitch from Tees. High.
This is not a bad pitch right here to try and create some action. The next pitch is better if it goes 3-2.
At one point, Tees sat down 10 in a row. One out base runner here. And he hooks this one foul. Again, the winner of this game we'll take on Bama State, Alabama State later on. Coming up next, it will be Southern and Bethune-Cookman. The winner of that game will play Grambling tonight at 6. The 2-2. Just
now,
missed.
I definitely would send him on this one. I definitely would send him. Okay, the coach is telling him, look like he's telling him hold on at first.
Burrows with one stolen base during the year. Will he go? No. Yeah. And off the end of the bat, this is tough. Pitcher feels, bare hand, the throw is there. It's a little tough, tricky play there by the pitcher Tees.
He had an advantage, though. If that ball had been down third base, see, he went at the ball under control. Look how he stopped, was able to stop, gained his control. Had it been on the third baseline, he'd have to be more aggressive.
Marshall Jonas at the plate, a chance for the Panthers to tie this game.
Coach, is it easier for the pitcher going to the first baseline because he's falling that way anyway?
In a right-hander, yes. And he's got the confidence, Charles. He's closer to the bag, you understand? You know, and he can see most of the thing, the action. If he was going to third base, all the action is to his back. And so there is always the fear of the unknown. If you don't know what's going on, you have a tendency to rush.
Well, a chance here, Roger Cador, for the Panthers.
To tie this game.
We do expect a low-scoring game at this point. I mean, you got, for the Panthers, this is their second elimination game. And for the Panthers, their first elimination game. And for the Rattlers, their second.
No, this is the second for the Panthers. Texas Southern was an elimination, and this one.
So it's Prairie View. They lost 11-1, so the Panthers, they won, so it's their second elimination game.
Yeah, second, yeah. And this is FAMU first.
This is their first, correct.
Yeah. You were right, you just had the schools.
Are you surprised at this low-scoring game so far?
To an extent, but after hearing the coach from FAMU talk about the flatness of his team, I guess you can't be, you know, they're still flat. So they're not doing well swinging the bat. Prairie View shouldn't be flat because they had more rest time, am I correct? And the coach was working with them if they had stayed with his philosophy, up the middle. Oh, look at this.
Now they have the runner hung up and the throw to third, the tag, he's safe. And I wonder will Coach Shoot take a look at this.
He bet not, don't burn it.
You get two challenges.
I wouldn't burn it. We can see here, Charles. Let's see.
Throw across.
Safe.
Yes, he is safe. Good camera work.
Good umpire. Umpire's right on it.
To your point, Coach, the dugout was politicking for it, but Coach Shoup didn't flinch.
Yeah, didn't flinch. Yeah, you got to save it.
And a fly ball to center ends the inning. Good camera work. Ump was right on it. Good operation all the way around. And the Rattlers get out of the inning as well. So we'll take a timeout here. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning. The Rattlers trying to add to their 1-0 lead. We'll be back after this as Michael Bastardo will lead it off. Perini and Hatermoto coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network. Yeah, Michael Bastardo leading it off. 1-0, the ball game here. quick ball game so far. A starter 0 for 2. Wide to first and short, 0 for 2. And the count is 2-0. Pitch from Crawl, Bastardo, fly ball in the left center. And coming in to make the catch is the left fielder Burrows, one away. And that's five straight set down. Pierini stands in. Pierini hit by a pitch and fly to short. So both pitchers, Roger Cato, on a little bit of a roll at one point in the game for the Panthers. Tease it set down 10 in a row. And now five straight set down here by Crawl.
Yeah, and the game is moving quite well. We're in the sixth inning. One team, FAMU got four hits. Prairie View's got three hits or five. My eyes are playing tricks on me.
Yeah, FAMU's out, hit them 5-4.
Yeah.
And two hopper to short. Strong throw across right on the button by Donato.
Yeah, good defense is being played also. We don't have any errors. The game is clean. And this is what you want to see, you know.
Six in a row set down. Adam Hatermoto stands in, hit one fielder's choice and struck out. Pitch strike call. The only run scored in this game in the third inning. All with two out. Jackson singled as the pitcher fell down to field the ball. Then Hanchy singled and an RBI double by Weber scored Jackson. It's the only run so far in this game.
Nobody was expecting that low of a scoring game. Because, you know, the third game, you're usually a little short on pitching, too, you know?
And of course, Florida A&M had a four-run lead. And let it slip. Here's a base hit, taking it the other way off the bat of Hatermoto. And that breaks the string of six straight set down, and he's on base for the second time. It'll bring up Jalen Niles. Take a look at this Roger Cador. Just poked it up the middle.
Yeah, couldn't get his glove down on it. But still, it's still good pitching being done. You know, you got Niles up.
It's the bottom of the lineup. And we've talked about it. The bottom of the lineup here for FAMU with Hayter Mota's been on base twice. Niles once and a walk to Badger four times. Bottom of the lineup.
That's a hit.
And this inning continues. Niles makes it 2-on. He's 2-for-3. And that's the fifth time the last three have gotten on. Do you look at, maybe I overstated, but how important is that? Your 7, 8, 9 hitters, you look at the averages, traditionally low averages at the bottom. And yet you look here, FAMU, their last three batters have been on base five times to set up the top of the lineup. Is that an important thing to look at?
Well, yeah, this baseball is a unique sport. In football and basketball, you design things for your best players to be able to touch the ball. In baseball, you can't do that.
Yeah.
You have to take what it gives you at the point in the game when they come up. So as it relates to your question, yes, it is important that they're doing what they're doing. Now remember, they probably wasn't executing at a higher level during the season, but this is a different season now. It's compressed, and it's all about what can you do within a 3 or 4 game span, and who comes up on top are usually going to be the team that's going to win. Ooh, look at the bullpen for Prairie View. They're getting a little rubbed down.
Yeah,
they're getting ready.
Yeah, they're getting ready quickly, and that was a mound visit to get the bullpen ready. So with two out, back-to-back hits, Hatermoto, Niles, and now Badger at the plate. A chance here for FAMU to add to their 1-0 lead. Hitter coming up.
Coach, you talked yesterday about this game being a game of inches. We're literally taking a look at one run that was caused by the dew on the ground.
Right, right. That's Charles Edmonds thing to do. He said the residue. Hey, but Charles, you're right. It's such a game of inches, you know. And a lot of people don't look at it that way. But boy, when I was coaching, we talked a great deal to my players about it is a game of inches.
Well, we have a pinch hitter for Badger, Ben Kim, at the plate. The pitch to Kim just misses. So pinch hitter, the number 9 hole for the Rattlers, a chance to get another run and add to their 1-0 lead. Ben Kim, the sophomore from Tampa.
Tampa has had good baseball players over the years.
Pitch to Kim. This just misses.
That was a good pitch. The pitcher really wanted that one.
And the count is 3-0.
Umpires are human, too. They miss them every now and then.
Kim hit 220 during the regular season. Some two-out work here for the Rattlers. Good strike call, 3-1.
I would rather try and get this man out rather than have to deal with Jackson in the undecked circuit. Got him the last time to hit back to the mound, but he may be poised to do some damage. So I would go after this man here, coming off the bench.
Here's the 3-1. Full count. So from 3-0 to a full count, two out. Hader Mota and Niles will be running on this pitch. Rattlers with a 1-0 lead have out-hit the Panthers 7-4. Here's the 3-2. Call, third strike on the inside corner. Side
you can't pitch
is
it and not swing the bat. He said it was inside.
Let's take a look at it here, Roger Cador.
Was it inside? Can we look at it again?
On the inner half.
Charles said inner half. He's got eyes like an eagle. No, that's a good pitch.
Side is retired, and the Rattlers strand two more. They have left 8 runners on base, so keep an eye on that as we roll along. 1-0, FAMU with the lead as we go to the 7th inning. Correa, Castro, and Donato coming up here from beautiful Atlanta here on the SWAC Digital Network. New catcher in the game for FAMU, Tyler Dunbar behind the plate. And at the plate is Correa, jumping on the first pitch. Deep short, long throw across is there, one out. Well, been busy shortstop as Niles.
A lot of one first pitch swinging. If you're going to swing at the first pitch, you got to do a good swing. Something you can drive.
Paul Castro for 2. 1-0, the Panthers trail here in the 7th inning. Wind blowing in, strike called.
As we said, the wind may be blowing on the flag, but the trees ain't moving. That is so unique. So I know why it's the urban jet stream.
is that a phrase, Charles Bishop, we're going to be taking with us for the next few years?
I mean,
let me brand it now.
And make sure you get the padding on it, okay?
Exactly.
Here's the pitch. This is outside. I mean, to your point, Roger Cador, as we look at it, flag is blowing, but you look at the trees, they're not.
Yeah.
Unless you look down here at right, they are.
But why aren't they blowing out here? That is what is so unique about it. I noticed that yesterday because I always, as when I was telling my players, we need to know the environment, what's going on. If you can't see the flag, look at the trees. Can't do that, pick some grass up, throw in the air. We want to find out what the element telling us.
How often do you do that during the course of the game?
Every inning, and if you have to. But there are times when you don't have to do it every inning because there is no wind.
Right.
You got me? You know. But certainly you want to do it when you first get out there, and late in the game you want to make sure that you don't have a surprise.
Pitch to Castro. Wasn't surprised there as he pulled this one foul. Bottom of the lineup for the Panthers. Once again, the loser of this game is eliminated. Two teams were eliminated yesterday, Texas Southern and Jackson State. What a tough loss for Jackson State. We've had two games that came down to the final at bat, as down goes Castro. FAMU lost it late. Jackson State lost it late.
When you say down goes Castro, I thought about a great box, George Fulmer and Joe Frazier. Down goes Frazier. You remember that call?
I do remember that.
Howard Cosell, what a great call.
Donato, 1-for-2. Strike called as we look ahead the bottom of the seventh inning, top of the lineup coming up.
I want to emphasize to all the young pitchers out there listening, look how easy this pitcher is throwing. Not very hard, but he's hitting his location. And look at the results he's getting.
And getting a lot of fly ball outs. And Cranko at first with the catch, and the side is retired. And that is 5 in a row set down by this pitcher. He's had two pretty good streaks going. 9 in a row, now 5 in a row. We go to the seventh inning stretch. Bottom of the seventh inning. 1-0 our score. The Rattlers with the lead. Top of the lineup coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to Atlanta, Georgia, McNeese Ballpark, the 2023 SWAC Baseball Tournament. First year in this beautiful city on this holiday weekend. Glad you can join us. We might have baseball tomorrow. We might not, depending on what happens with Alabama State and Grambling. If both those teams win today, there's no baseball tomorrow. They'll play for the championship on Sunday. However, one of these teams will move on, and if they beat Alabama State or Grambling, we might have a game tomorrow. We might have one game. We might have two games. We might not have a game tomorrow, depending on what happens. We've had that happen before, as Florida A&M trying to stay alive here in this seventh inning, trying to add to their advantage. Here's a base hit off the bat of Ty Jackson, left center field. He's 2-for-4.
We talked about why the pitcher didn't want to face Ty with the bases loaded last inning, you remember?
Ty Hanchy at the plate, yeah. And the leadoff is on. Hanchy 1-for-3. The Rattlers have out-hit the Panthers 8-to-4. And picking up left to right, pitch is outside, ball one.
This run is big. I would start the runner here, but I would let him get a strike because you want to keep that hole open before you do anything. There you go.
There's a base hit right field. Two on for the Rattlers. So singles by Jackson and Hanchy. Two on for FAMU. Now here comes Antoine Riggins. Antoine Riggins, his first trip to the mound.
Well, it's going to be significant because he's making a change. He's gotten about all he can out of his pitcher.
And just with this being a 1-0 lead, he's
taken. He took him to the seventh inning.
Coach, I gotta ask you, with no outs, is this a situation where you just want to move the runners over, but you have a power hitter at the plate? What's the play here?
Yeah, well, you can't take the bat out of his hand. That's the one thing you can't do, because he probably have never bunted a bunch in his career. So you know, the other thing, you don't want to ask a hitter to do something he's not accustomed to doing. So we'll tell him take his normal swing. If you get a pitch away, you want to hit it to the right side. That way you can advance the runners.
Well, we talked about that yesterday with Texas Southern's big hitter Olivo. You don't want to take the bat out of a big guy's hands, especially if they're capable of hitting it out of the park.
Yes.
Weber at the plate. He's doubled. He's got the only RBI. His double score, Jackson. He's flying to center and struck out. Well, he's sacrificing here. Pitch is low.
I'm a little surprised, but, you know, I don't know that much about the coach's philosophy and what Weber is capable of doing. If he was my big guy, he wouldn't be bunting.
Well, he hit 316 during the year with 7 home runs. There's a pickoff in the throw, and safe at first. Just getting back in is Jackson.
Ooh. That shouldn't happen, Jackson. Action, Jackson.
All right, let's take a look at it here.
He got it. Touched him on his chest.
Here's the 1-0. And he bunts it foul.
Now, he's got the right idea. If you bunt it, you want to try and make the third baseman feel it, because he should be – third baseman should be even with the bag and then come in. See, that way if he starts even with the bag, he can still peripheral, see what the run at second is doing. Now he doesn't know, or now he turned him himself.
There's the 1-1 inside.
It hit the umpire.
Jamie Shoup said, take your base.
No, it didn't hit the hitter. Yeah.
And the hitter. Weber saying it didn't hit him.
No, it didn't, because he would have shown some action.
Oh, it caught the umpire.
Yeah, it hit the umpire. I knew it hit him.
And time is called here. Got a conversation. I mean, the replay clearly shows.
Yeah, I knew it hit the umpire.
Clearly shows that it hit the umpire. And now the crew will huddle up. Augustus Griffin behind the plate, Joseph Smith, Calvin Hill, and Derek Everett, our crew for this game one, day three. Jamie Shoup, you heard him say, take your base.
Ooh, hit him, ooh.
But it actually caught the home plate umpire.
Above the knee?
1-2 the count. 1-0. There's on at first and second. This is popped up. Our territory, is there a play? No. Well, now the count is 1-2. Roger Cador and Weber's got to protect the plate.
He certainly have to do that.
Well, Charles Bishop, an opportunity here for the Rattlers, clinging to a 1-0 lead, but they've got two on, none out.
Big opportunity here with no outs here. I tell you what, you got to find something you like and drive it.
I do see a little in right center field, the just beyond the center field wall, the tree very top, moving just a little. If you look, Charles, you got to look hard. Right by the foul pole and by the right of the center field wall.
Well, my vision's not that good, far away. Okay. Here's a long fly ball in the deep left field.
He's gonna catch it.
It's against the wind, and it's going to be caught in left.
Oh, this stop!
And they go back to their respective bases.
Action, Jackson, in action. A scared man can't gamble, and a jealous man can't leave home. And that's what it indicated to me right there.
Burrows with the catch. That was hit against the wind. It definitely held it up at the track. Coming in, makes the catch. Now, what was the proper play there as far as the base running is concerned?
He should have tagged. Listen, you're playing with house money. That's why I said a scared man can't gamble and a jealous man can't leave home. He showed both of them on that. Okay, well, he might get him out here.
Greco, a foul off to the right side. So it should have been a tag up in advance on that fly ball.
Yeah.
Well, two on, one out here in a big moment in this game.
Coach, you're really dropping some gems. A scared man can't gamble.
Well, Charles doesn't like it. You notice he didn't respond.
Well, he's right. Well, he's right. I mean, I have heard that before. Yeah. He is correct.
Oh, no, a scared man can't gamble, and a jealous man ain't leaving home. And that's what Jackson showed. He got scared. You can't be afraid to fail in a game of failure.
One and one the count. Two on.
What are the odds that man against the wall?
Here's a ground ball to first. Three, four, and a double play. Man, what a way that was turned.
Really turned.
3-6-4 double play. Let's take a look at it, Roger Cador.
Really good play by your first baseman. Really good play.
Excellent.
I mean, he did it big league. He didn't hesitate. He trusted what he could do. Now, he wasn't scared.
6-3 double play, and the side is retired. So that takes care of the Panthers in a big situation right there. And we'll take a break right here. We'll be right back. Now that's a heck of an opportunity for the Rattlers, and the double play ends it. We'll be back with the eighth inning after this on the SWAC Digital Network.
You want to come up here? You want to come up here?
Welcome back. We are live here in Atlanta. Glad you can join us. Jaden Williams leading it off. Wide to first and left.
See, that first swing, that's not the swing you got to have. You need a healthy swing. You're down by one. A half swing ain't going to do it unless you have two strikes and you're protecting.
Panthers are down 1-0.
So all you young people who out there may be watching, remember, your first strike should be a healthy swing.
Count is 2-1. Strike call, 2-2.
And that's why I used to love being in the third base box, because I would be yelling that to my players. You got me, Charles? Now, that's a good swing there. He's got two strikes. He want to fight it off and buy a better pitch.
The Panthers just trying to get a runner on. They're only down 1-0. Low scoring game, elimination game. He's up and in.
See, that's why you foul tough pitches off. You force the count.
Again, the winner of this game will play Alabama State later.
Look at here.
Leadoff is on.
Remember,
tying run at first.
Especially when he walks in the eighth and ninth inning, the percentage of him scoring skyrocketing. Now they've got somebody warming up in the. There we go, coach.
Jamie Shoup coming out. Get his bullpen busy. Well,
he's gonna
make the change right now. So a pitching change coming up here. The leadoff is on for the Panthers. As the Rattlers take a 1-0 lead, we'll take a break. We'll give you the next pitcher for Florida A&M as Dallas Tease getting the start, gets his team in the eighth. We'll take a break. We'll be right back after this on the SWAC Digital Network.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
And we welcome you back. Zach Maria on the mound for Florida A&M. And for Zach, this is his third appearance in the tournament. He's pitched an inning and a third. And he is their best in terms of closing the game out. So Roger Cador, you get late into these games and you look at FAMU's Dallas Tees, 7 innings pitch, no runs, 4 hits, struck out 2 and walked 2, and the runner at first belongs to him. So we'll see how Maria does here.
Yeah,
trying to keep his team in the lead.
We shall see.
Sidewinder.
Coach, right. We got another guy that comes from down under. How do we go about attacking
him? Well, the same thing, same approach. You want to stay on the ball a little longer, hit it the other way. If you pull off of it, you're going to end up probably not making any contact or hitting it right off the end of the bat. So think right center field on him, and it'll allow you to stay on the ball a lot longer.
Wise at the plate, throw over to first, runner's back. Wise 1-for-3, grounded to third and fly to second.
I gotta think he should be sacrificing here. Is that part of the game when you gotta get him over?
Leadoff is on for the Panthers. Yep, squaring the bunt, bunts it straight back. It's always tough when you get these three-quarter sidewinder pitchers trying to see the ball off his hand. It's always tough.
That's why it's tougher for kids to stay in there. But if you stay in there, the ball becomes a lot more hittable if you don't fear the ball. But in this case, he just needs to bunt it.
I'm trying to keep Williams close. At first, Jaden Williams, 7 stolen bases during the regular season. Tying run at first, go ahead, run at the plate. 1-0, FAMU. The bunt, oh, and that caught the umpire again, yeah. And the throw across, the stolen base. The ball caught the home plate umpire again. Augustus Griffin.
He got beat this time. I heard it.
He spun flesh. Out of the way.
He got flesh.
And the runner takes second. Boy, he stepped out of there pretty quickly.
Yeah, he's wincing pretty good down here. He's trying to smile it off, but that one hit him right on the forearm.
He has left forearm.
Got some flesh. They don't have the freeze. Back in the days, they had the freeze. You could freeze that stuff. Freon, what's it called? Whatever.
Yeah, it looks like Prairie View's trainer's going to come out. I wonder, is that freeze what they have in the little spray bottle?
Usually it's free. They use the spray on the flesh, but it looks like they're putting it on the pad and rubbing it now.
Yep, right around the elbow area. Yeah. Home plate umpire, Augustus Griffin. Getting a little treatment. Well, I said it the other day, Roger Cador, catchers and umpires, they catch it all back there.
Umpire catch more than the catchers because they get the abuse. Don't tell me we're going to need to replace him. He doesn't want to be replaced.
I wonder what are the analytics on umpires getting hit, especially with sidewinders up there.
That's a good question. I wouldn't know. Yeah, twice in the two and one back-to-back inning. That's highly unusual. Some umpires go 2 or 3 years without being nicked.
I'm sure Dan Quisenberry, Kent Tekulve, those guys get a lot of umpires.
Yes, they did. Because the catchers get tricked if that ball backs up on the catchers. You got me? That's the problem. The umpires get hit because the ball is spinning backward.
Well, Augustus Griffin, the home plate umpire, is okay. The count is 1-1. More importantly, as far as the game is concerned, the Panthers have the tying run at second base.
If he gets hits again, we're really going to be in trouble. Still the bunt is on.
Maria misses low. Count is 2-1. Lead off walk to Williams. Pitch got him to second. Here in the eighth, there's a bunt foul down the left side. Well, bunting is an art, Roger Cador. You see a lot of bunt attempts, so many try to do it. How much in practice as a coach, how much time spent in practice every day did you work on these situations trying to lay down a good bunt?
Not a lot. No, I didn't do it a lot because we had good offensive people, but I didn't have a lot of people who could do it.
Here's the 2-2. It's a sliced in this right center, shallow right center, and it's caught for the out.
Action Jackson.
And Ty Jackson hauls it in. One away, and it'll bring up the second baseman, Zachary Trevino. He's 1-for-3, an infield single, fly to center and left. Tying run is at second base in this elimination game. Again, the loser of this game is eliminated. The third team eliminated in this tournament. The winner will take on Alabama State. Scheduled for 3:00. Maria ahead of the count.
They have to come back really quick. They won't be able to go home and sleep.
That's the other tough part about it. When you get to this point, you're playing a doubleheader. Stay alive, coming out of the loser's bracket. Just high.
Iron Man baseball.
Yep.
Of course, for Prairie View, they lost to Alabama State 11-1, eliminated Texas Southern 9-6. For FAMU, they beat Texas Southern and lost on the final at bat to Alabama State. Here's a little fly ball, shallow right, but it's going to be caught at second. Perini hauls it in.
They're down to four outs. That's what Coach Hugh is talking now. He's looking at how can I get four more outs out of this pitcher, because nobody's warming up.
Bring up Michael Burrows. He's been on base twice, an infield single and a walk. Williams is at second with two out. Side ball one. Mac Maria on the mound for the Rattlers, his third appearance in the tournament. He is their closer.
He's that closer. He's got it in his hand.
Here's the 1-0. 1-1.
You got the whole world in your hand. You've heard that before?
I've heard that one before, yes.
You approve of it?
He's got the game in his hand right now.
That's the whole world. That's in his world right now.
Here's the 1-1. Misses outside, 2-1. Low scoring tilt here in day three. Game one, elimination game. Jackson State, Texas Southern were eliminated yesterday. The loser of this game is eliminated. Another elimination game coming up, Southern and Bethune-Cookman. Here's the 2-1.
He's trying to do too much. Go right at it.
3-1 the count. Boy, FAMU controlled the situation yesterday. Let it slip away late against Bama State. He's 1-0 here. Panthers trying to stay alive. Panthers with only four hits, but an opportunity to tie the game. Here in the eighth. Time called. Runners at first.
Oh, the time clock? What happened? It couldn't be a bug because the runner didn't advance at second.
No.
They did this. What does that mean, Charles?
The runner gets first base.
Oh, look at here. So what? They're doing, the time clock has got to be there because that's the only thing else you could be.
Called it a pitch.
Well, it's got to be time clock pitch, right?
Charles Bishop? What?
Yeah.
Yeah, they called it a pitch clock violation.
Pitch clock. I said time, but you got it right.
So runners on at first and second. Maria's wondering what happened. And Jamie Shoup's going to come out. And he's going to pay his pitcher a visit. So two on here for the Panthers.
I didn't know the time clock was in existence because where is it located? If Charles don't know, I don't know.
I'll get clarification on it. I asked Coach Rickin, so I'll get clarification real quick.
And I think for Coach Shoup just trying to settle his pitcher down in this moment. I think that's what
I just got a text. It's the 22nd clock, time clock. So you don't need to ask him. I got it. Just didn't know they were using it. Charles Edmund didn't tell me.
Well, that's the first that we've seen as far as I know.
That's right. It is the first one.
Well, two on for the Panthers. So two on for PBU. An opportunity here to tie the game. This pitch is low, ball one.
You know, this thing could get ugly right here for FAMU. It could get ugly.
1-0 the count. Pitch to Martinez. I'll tip, catcher held it. Martinez fouled out, fly to center, and back to the pitcher. Two on for PVU. The Panthers have left four. This pitch misses outside. 2-1. One the count. 2-1 for the Panthers. 1-0. BAMU. Oh, late swing, fouled it off the mask. The Rattler catcher, Badger. Late change, Tyler Dunbar is catching for FAMU. Off the mask of Dunbar. The 2-2. And there's a foul ball down the left side.
A game of inches, Charles.
Yeah, if we can take a look at that, how close that was.
It's about a foot.
Let's see, it was foul. How close was it? Oh, yeah. That was about a foot. Mm-hmm. Count is even, 2-2. Two out, two on. It's for Maria. It's one outside, full count.
The information I just got is that the umpires keep the 20-second clock on the field. Usually the second base umpire have it. So now we got it.
Haven't seen that used that much.
Yeah.
Big pitch here, 3-2. Fly ball down the left side.
That ball is
carrying. And it's caught right up against the wall.
Where's the urban jet stream?
Weber hauls it in. Two runners stranded. That ball carried right up against the wall. As you see, we're going back, a step from the wall. He hauls it in. As Roger Cador says, it's a game of inches. Side is retired. We'll take a break here. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. 1-0, FAMU. When we come back, Bastardo, Perini, and Hayter Mota coming up after this on the SWAC Digital Network. Welcome back. Miguel Bastardo at the plate. He's 0-3. Fly to short left and fly to first. Charles Edmond, the Hall of Famer, Roger Cador. Charles Bishop down on the field. Roger Cador, you got a little clarity in between innings on that pitch clock violation.
Yes, I did. The third base umpire is the one that keeps the clock at all time. So he's the one that made the call. about the 22nd violation. So now we know, Charles, we didn't know before. Now we got it right. And that's the key. We want to make sure we get things right as we give the information to our listening audience or viewing audience.
So we got to keep an eye a little bit on the third base umpires. He's keeping that time.
Yes.
And what you see in a lot of collegiate stadiums, they have the clock out in left or right center. Hopper to short. The throw across is there. One away.
We still hadn't had an error, so everything is working really good.
Clean game. Joseph Pierini hit by a pitch, grounded to short, fly to short. One out, base is empty. 1-0, Rattlers. Pierini, a fly ball foul off to the left side. Again, the winner of this game will take on Bama State at 3. Coming up next, it'll be Bethune-Cookman and Southern. The winner of that game will take on Grambling tonight at 6. Here's a pitch, strike called. FAMU is out hit, Prairie View 9-4.
And I'm watching the third base umpire. He has got the clock. He's touching something every time a pitch is made.
He has something on his right hip.
There you go.
Here's the pitch. Fastball call, third strike, two out.
I mean, this kid has really pitched his heart out. You know.
Matthew Crawl, the sophomore, 4-4. And the only run that was given up, you can make the case, Charles Bishop, probably shouldn't have happened. A ground ball, pitcher slips, get a couple of hits and a run. Tough break.
Tough break. You talk about a game of inches. I mean, we go back to that play. It was a simple play that Coach Kater said, you got to turn your body.
That's right.
Get in position to make the play. And look, it's that one run.
I mean, this is really just amazing. I didn't anticipate this being – this quality of a game, but it's really for people who love low scoring games, pitch and duel. You had it today, you know, and there are people like the fans yesterday for the FAMU Alabama State game. They love offense, they wanted it, and they got it. They had a lot of action.
Well, there's some action here as Hiromoto with a walk. And Jalen Niles stands in. He's been on base twice, 2-for-3. So, again, I go back to that theme, Roger Cador, the last three batters in the lineup. Hader, Mota, Niles, and, well, now Dunbar. They've been on base 7 times in the bottom of the lineup. Even though it's just a 1-0 game, you say the bottom of the lineup has stirred the pot a little bit for FAMU. Niles, 2-for-3.
Yeah, they've done a good job.
Two-out base runner. Pitch strike called. Good outing for the sophomore righty, Matthew Crawl. 60 2/3 innings pitched during the regular year. Held the Rattlers to 1 run so far. Fastball strike called.
And he's pounding the strike zone. You know.
Count is 1-2. It's up and in, 2-2. Two, 2-2 pitch. Just got a piece of it. It's a foul ball. Count remains 2-2. You look ahead to the 9th inning. It'll be the middle of the lineup. 5, 6, and 7. Jonas Correa, Castro. 2-2. Oh, the foul off to the right side.
So the bottom part of the order for Prairie View would have to do it to get the job done for him.
And you look at that, Castro 0-for-3. Donato 1-for-3. Williams 0-for-2. There's the 2-2 with two out. This is full count.
If we win basketball, we would design the play for Michael Jordan.
Full count, 3-2, two out.
Oh, Steph Curry, huh?
3-2.
Ooh.
Just missed ball four. 2-1.
Nile has had himself a hell of a series thus far.
He's been on base three times. Let's look at this pitch, Roger Cator. How close was this?
Well, it was out there. It was out there.
Froze it. Well, when you have a catcher that can freeze frame it for the umpires.
Correction. It's the catcher, number 30,
Tyler Dunbar, who took the place of Badger a couple of innings ago. A big spot for the Rattlers, the number 9 hitter for FAMU.
If you're going to be able to do something, you need the bottom of the order to do it.
Big swing and a miss.
Mama can't come hold your hand here. And daddy can't say you throw that ball where my son can hit it. Huh?
Count is 0-1.
Can't say that.
Rattlers have had a lot of opportunities in this game. Fly ball foul. Right now they have two on. They've left 8 runners on base.
Way too many. Make a good pitch here.
Fastball just missed. Well, you have to give this pitcher, Crawl, a lot of credit for hanging in.
Yeah.
Count is 1-2. Two out, 2 on. The pitch. Up and in. 2-2.
You don't want to miss an up and in. You want to stay out there.
Two and two the count with two on. Full count. Big pitch right here. Full count, 3-2, two out. One to nothing. Rattlers trying to add to it here in the eighth.
Ooh.
Handing over. Foul tip. Catcher held it. Side is retired.
That's what being a Bulldog looks like, Coach.
Yeah, it is. Oh, he's been a Bulldog today.
Let's look at it, Roger Cator, right here.
Right down the middle.
Blew it right by him. 10 stranded by the Rattlers. They were in this similar position yesterday. They had a 4-run lead yesterday. Now they have a 1-run lead here. Top of the 9th inning coming up for the Panthers. We'll get to it after this timeout on the SWAC Digital Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways. Everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet. Honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Stop the light. I don't say a word.
We go to the top of the ninth inning. Good ball game here. 1-0. If you like good starting pitching, good pitching overall, this is your game. If you like offense, this is not your game. 1-0. We go to the top of the ninth inning. Marshall Jonas, the DH. Zach Maria, two saves during the regular season. Third appearance here in this postseason.
Don't go inside.
And the first pitch is inside to Jonas. He's 0-3.
Jonas got his first home run of the year yesterday over left center.
Yeah, he certainly did hit it pretty good.
And if he does the same here, it'll tie it up. Pitch is high.
Remember, the history of walking the leadoff hitter has been prevalent in this series or the tournament.
Well, the Panthers have not had a base hit since the fifth inning, and he was hit by the pitch. And the tying run is at first.
That's one of the things about those side winders. They're prone to hit right-hand hitters.
Will there be a pinch runner here for Jonas? Yes, sir. Pinch runner for the Panthers. Isaac Davila will pinch run. A little speed represents the tying run.
But you said good things happen if you just stay in there, huh?
Oh, yeah, just stay in there. Don't ever quit.
Oh, Davila represents the tying run. And the winning run, Sebastian Correa, 0-3, grounded to short twice and flied to center. Squaring the butt, takes a strike.
Third baseman got to watch it running in like that. Got bunted over his head. See, those are the kind of thing. He looked like he's a new third baseman. So you have to run in there under control. Let him at least square. Don't run in there. Ooh, should have hit him.
Pitch in on him, protected himself, and fouled it off. And now he's got to protect the plate. Let's look at this, Roger Cador. That was right in on him.
Yeah, take it. Well, you don't want to let it hit you in the chest. Ooh, look at that. Right there in the middle of his chest.
Now he has to protect the plate. He's in the hole, 0-2. Almost chased it, sailed outside, 1-2.
This pitcher is going to struggle right here. You know, he hadn't thrown a strike yet.
Tying run at first. Jonas was hit by a pitch. Villa pinch ran for him, and he's at first.
Ooh,
one out.
Helped him. Helped him.
The winner of this game will play Alabama State, scheduled for 3 o'clock. Loser of this game's eliminated. Paul Castro, the catcher, struck out twice, grounded to second. 1-0. Panthers have had 4 base runners since the fifth inning, but they haven't had a base hit since the fifth inning.
And that's the key. You got to get a hit.
And that was a 2-out single by Wise, but was caught stealing. It's the last base hit that the Panthers have had. Throw to first. Since that time in the sixth, they were issued a walk. They were issued a walk in the eighth, 2 walks in the eighth, and a batter hit in this ninth inning.
I may be tempted to try and hit and run, get the runner started. I may try to create an opening in the defense here. There you go.
Runner's going, pitches a strike, to throw across on the tackle and hit him.
Oh, go, get up.
It hit him in the helmet. And a stolen base. Villa, let's take a look at that. 0-1 is the count. Let's take a look at it.
He had the right idea. He started him.
Good jump. Strike call to throw across.
The problem with that.
The problem with that
was where the second baseman. He should have been in front of the bag. He was behind, which caused the problem. Because now the runner is going to put a cause a problem for him. See that? Look where the second baseman got to be in front of the bag.
K Count is 1-1, one out. Tying run at second, winning run at the plate. Check swing, strike called.
You see, little things come back and play big, become big, Charles, if you don't fundamentally do them right. You got me?
Well, a chance for the Panthers here. You agree with that stolen base situation?
Yes, I really agree. You need to be aggressive because that's going to give his team a better chance of being successful. They're not going to hit the ball out the park. So you need to move, put people in motion, open up holes in the defense.
Count is 2-2, one out, runner at second, 1-0 Rattlers.
Ooh.
Just low.
Now, I'm not saying take off and steal third. That's not what I'm advocating. They've got him in second, but he's on second. So any kind of hit here could give him a chance to score.
Go ahead, run at the plate. Paul Castro, count is full with one out, runner at second.
Castro's got a baby face.
Here's the pitch. Call, third strike. Caught looking.
Oh, come on.
Two out.
You shouldn't have taken that.
Oh, he had some words with Hunter Dunbar right there. Plate umpire breaks it up. On the outside corner. Two out.
So many people are so sensitive nowadays. You took the pitch, so what if the catcher says something? You know.
Two out.
I better be quiet.
Maldonado at the plate. His pitch strike called. Maria trying to end it. Donato trying to tie the game or extend the inning.
I don't understand. Kids want to win and won't swing the bat. You got to swing the bat in order to hit the ball. And you take the umpire out of the equation.
Donato 1-for-3. It's a wild pitch. Karam's on a line, and the runner does
good,
not
good
take
Good heads
third.
Up. Good heads up. You see, he's been paying attention. The ball has come back every time when it hits that wall.
So you agree with him not taking a chance to try to get
no.
to third?
He's already in scoring position here. So you don't want to take that chance.
1-1 the count.
And he's taking a good lead, which means if he gets a hit, he's going to be able to score. The arm, I know center fielder Action Jackson does have a good arm.
Count is 2-1. Jonas was hit by a pitch. Pinch runners at second. The pitch. Check swing, strike call on the inside corner.
You're going to have to swing the bat in order to get this run in.
The count is 2-2. FAMU lost a tough one-run game yesterday. They lead 1-0 here. Maria trying to extend the Rattlers' season. Here comes the 2-2 with two out, runner at second. Inning over, that's your ball game. The Rattlers advance. They survive and advance to take on Alabama State, eliminating the Prairie View Panthers. 1-0 our score. Good ball game, good low scoring game, and a tough break for the Prairie View Panthers.
The tournament needed a quick game. They got it. Charles, you delivered.
Good chess match, good ball game. Opportunities.
Yeah. Presented itself, no one took advantage of it. Other than when FAMU got the one hit with the one runner they had in scoring position.
So our score 1-0, Charles Bishop, a good ball game.
Real good game.
Tremendous ball game. When you talk about a well-pitched game, both teams, nothing to really hang your head about. I tell you what, both pitchers just bulldogs in this game.
Charles Bishop standing by with the post-game interviews as we get ready for game two coming up. right, Charles Bishop, it's all yours.
Yeah, down here with Dallas T's, tremendous ball game. 107 pitches. You went seven strong innings. What was the key today?
Man, just get ahead early, let them get themselves out. You know, you're at this point in the tournament. You got to, you know, save as much pitching as possible. So just try to stay ahead, let them get themselves out, and save some arms because we're going to need it. We got a long road back, and I'm looking forward to it.
How were you going about the process of pitching Prairie View today?
Like I said, just getting ahead. They were very early swingers, so when I was throwing my off speed, I was kind of just letting them get themselves out, and I just felt very dominant about it. And, you know, their pitcher did great. I, you know, pitch for pitch, match up with him, but it was good. No.
Like you said, you saved a bullet today. Go celebrate with your team, buddy.
I appreciate it. You have a good one.
All right, Charles Bishop. Good job there. And it sets up another Bama State FAMU matchup later on. And Roger Cador, your thoughts on this one nothing game. You know, these elimination games, you wonder how many arms you got. You wonder how many runs could be given up. But something different here in this first game, day three.
Yeah, it was different. You're not going to see too many one nothing game on day three. That's highly unusual, but we got it today. And the game was well played. It just wasn't a bunch of hits. And so we got it done.
All right, so the Rattlers move on. Prairie View eliminated. Later, they will take on Bama State. We'll step aside. Coming up in about a half an hour, we'll have our other elimination matchup, Bethune-Cookman and the Jaguars of Southern University. That is coming up next. We'll send it back in about 30 minutes. The Wildcats and Jaguars coming up from Atlanta on the SWAC Digital Network.